left to go wild. A month of no strimming or cutting, untidy or a pollinator paradise.
No Mow May has been fantastic this year, and it's really important for everyone to get behind it, because if we can all give just 10% of our gardens to pollinators, to feed the pollinators, then we'll help boost the numbers and keep them alive.
The great thing about this garden, as you can see, it's not a massive garden where somebody's put, you know, half an acre aside for No Mow May. It's actually quite a small garden. It's the only garden with this house. And it looks absolutely fantastic. It's so sculptural, the way that the paths have been cut through it, and you can drift through them, through the trees, and at the same time, with the wildflowers growing, it's, you know, it's great for nature and great for bees.
We were at St Peter's Open Gardens, and it was fantastic to see how many people had embraced the No Mow May project and let a part or all of their garden grow longer, grow wild. So there were so many wildflowers with pollen and nectar for pollinators that fed them. And it's really important that people do this.
Leaving the lawnmower in the shed for a month would hardly have been a hardship for many islanders. But by law, hedges that overhang a public road must be cut back up to a height of over 3.5 metres. That law is now over 65 years old, and there are calls to modernise it for the benefit of the bugs. Jersey changed theirs recently to be more sympathetic to nature.
Road safety is the main concern when it comes to running the broncage, but I think there's lots of other things to take into consideration. Thinking about the wildlife that might be living in those hedgerows, the broncage has just started for this year. I've seen some quite sensitive cutting going on. I think the tide's starting to turn, but I think that message is slowly getting out there to be a bit more aware of the environment and about the wildlife as well as the road safety aspect.
Buzzing in their intentionally wild surroundings. And it's not just the bees that approve. Ewan Duncan, BBC Channel Islands News.